you've got a new maxTV Stream media box. Let's get it set up. If you're a brand new maxTV Stream subscriber, you'll first need a Google account. If you're an existing maxTV Stream subscriber adding a new media box, have your Google login info close by. Then skip ahead to the Connect to TV section of this video. If you don't already have a Google account, visit accounts.google.com/signup and create one. Logging in with a Google account is important to ensure your media box receives regular updates. With your Google account info close by, we're ready to connect the box. Start by connecting one end of the supplied HDMI cable into the back of the media box and the other end into your TV. At this time, you can also connect to your internet gateway using an Ethernet cable if one is near your media box. Although connecting over Ethernet is preferred, you can opt to connect via Wi-Fi instead. Connecting to Wi-Fi comes later in the setup. Your next step is to connect the media box to power with the supplied power cord. Then, turn on your TV and make sure your TV is set to the correct HDMI input. Your media box should soon start up, and you'll see the following screen. While you're waiting, put the supplied batteries into the maxTV Stream remote control. When you see the message, "Connect your remote control," highlight Connect and press OK on the maxTV Stream remote. Wait while your remote automatically pairs with your media box. The screen will let you know when you're all set. If you have an Android smartphone, you may be asked if you'd like to set your TV up with it. You can skip this step if you want. If you didn't connect to the internet using an Ethernet cable earlier, now you'll be asked to connect to Wi-Fi. Select your Wi-Fi network from the list, then enter your Wi-Fi password, then select the check mark on the keyboard when finished. To see more characters on the keyboard, press and hold the OK button. Once successfully connected to the internet, your media box will do some updates. This may take up to 20 minutes. Once the updates are completed, you'll see a black screen before your media box restarts. Once restarted, the media box will confirm your remote control has already been paired. Sign into your Google account using the on-screen keyboard, then accept the terms of service. If you have two-factor authentication set up on your Google account, you may receive a text message. If you want, you can set up Google Assistant for voice control on your media box. Watch the screens and follow the prompts. Pick a name for your maxTV Stream media box and press the OK button. This name helps you identify the media box when connecting to it from other devices. Now you have the option to install additional apps. Select the apps you want to install. Apps already associated with your Google account will be pre-selected. You can always install more apps later from the Google Play Store. After you install your apps, the media box will show you a few features of your maxTV Stream subscription and media box. Next, you can set up your maxTV Stream media box remote to control your TV's power and volume. Follow the prompts. Your media box is set up. Now you're ready to log in to your maxTV Stream service. At the maxTV Stream login screen, select Yes and press OK to automatically log in. And that's it. Now sit back and enjoy maxTV Stream. For more help, including troubleshooting, how to use maxTV Stream, or setting up maxTV Stream on Apple TV or on your phone, visit the maxTV Stream support hub at sasktel.com/maxTV Stream support.